There is a door here.
Yeah, what is it? The people all first open? So what kind of way up? Look like here is the fire people and go through the
around the world, and also to implement measures related to human rights issue. And the organization I was telling you about a little bit is this one. It's the WTO, World Trade Organization. It does not belong to the United Nations. So that's why they put it a little bit aside with the white color in order to make the difference. Because the United Nations has its own organization dealing with trade. It's this one. The UN 680, the United Nations Trade Conference. The lake and the Mont Blanc, and the other one facing the Jura. So it was built from 1929, they started in 1929, and they finished it in 1936. So this used to be the headquarters of the League of Nations. As I told you before, the League of Nations was established in 1919, after the First World War, in order to promote peace and international security, but unfortunately, it could not manage it and avoid a Second World War, and was replaced by the United Nations. And the member countries of the League of Nations, all of them, they contributed financially and also materially in order to build, they organized the big conferences. Those large conferences are attended by people from everywhere. And this room can accommodate up to 2,000 people. This is the biggest room. We have this floor first, the ground floor, which is for four delegates. You have the first one, with the microphones for observers. The second one is for the press, the journalists, and also here, we have this floor, the first one, for the journalists. And on the top, you know, with the glass, always for security reasons, we have the public, always on the top. And we have also the interpreter here on this side. So this room is where the League of Nations held its last meeting in 1945, and the UN took over. And also they organized many other big conferences, like for instance, the International Atomic Agency, which is in Vienna. It was established here in 1953. We have also the International Maritime Organization, which is in London, which was also established in this room as well. And in 1988, there was a special meeting organized by the Second Council. Protected by two leaves of olive tree, because the olive tree traditionally represents peace. So that's why the UN selected this this logo in order to represent it. Also Spanish room, because all the decoration you can see here is made by a Spanish artist called Jose Maria Sepp. He's from a village called Vic near Barcelona. He's a Catalan, and he started in 1932. And 1 year later, a civil war broke out in Spain. He fled Paris, and that's where he finished it in 1936. And they were put on the wall. They are stuck to the wall. And inaugurated in 1937, so it took 4 years to do all the paintings here. And this room is where the United Nations organized this conference on the Zambia. You know, this is a conference established in the 70s, because at that time there were the Cold War between the West and in French they say Allemagne, so it will start with A, but this one is the German alphabetic order. And it's chaired by Norway. So this is the summer session, because they organize three sessions. They have winter, spring, and summer sessions. And after, you know, they make a final report and send it to New York, you know, for political decisions to be made. So here, also in this room, many, for instance, peace treaties and weapons treaty was signed here. To give just some examples, we have the peace treaty between France, Laos, and Cambodia in the late 50s, the Indochina War. You have also the peace treaty between Greece and Turkey about Cyprus in 1973. We have also the peace treaty between Israel and the Arab countries, the Yom Kippur War.